Hi guys, Jen here with How Jen Does It. I am so excited for the holidays. I wanted to share 7 ways that you can save money during this holiday season. So let's go ahead and jump right in. My very first tip is to have a budget. And I'm sure a lot of you have thought about your Christmas budget, but I wanted to remind you to budget for everything, not just gifts, but holiday cards, stamps. If you need to mail gifts out, be sure that's in your budget. Extra food if you are having little get-togethers or large get-togethers. If you do a lot of baking, be sure to budget for all of that. Another thing that I like to do with my budget is, rather than just having a large sum of money and a big list of gifts that I would like to purchase and all of the holiday things that I need to purchase, I will set a specific amount of money for each thing on my list, and that just keeps me on track rather than having a set amount of money and then spending like way too much on stocking stuffers or way too much on gift wrap. I know about how much I want to spend on each of those things, so it really keeps me on track. My second way to save money during this holiday season is to use cash. You have heard me talk about using cash before, but this really helps to stay on track, because when we're out and about at lots of stores, there are so many things that we could and may want to spend our money on, but handing over cash is so different than just handing over your credit card, and it really helps you to stay on track. I do shop online and I use a credit card online, but what I do is take that cash and put it aside for when the bill comes, and that way I can pay it off in full and I have no surprises after Christmas when the credit card bill comes. The third way to save money during this holiday season is by using RetailMeNot. RetailMeNot is sponsoring this video, so thank you very much to them. You guys have heard me talk about RetailMeNot before. I know a lot of you use them to save money on just about everything. And if you aren't already using RetailMeNot, you definitely don't want to miss out. RetailMeNot is incredibly easy to use. They even have a RetailMeNot holiday deals page. RetailMeNot now has cash back offers that you can combine with codes to save even more. You can save on everything you need for the holidays. So not only gifts and decor, but electronics, clothing, beauty, and much more. RetailMeNot also has a free app that I use all the time when I am out shopping. You can get alerts to offers nearby, and you can just redeem those right from your phone at checkout. And I save money so often by checking the RetailMeNot app. What makes it even better is that RetailMeNot is offering up to $1,000 to one lucky winner. Use the link below to sign up for RetailMeNot to enter the sweepstakes. By entering, you can also win a $25, $50, or $100 gift card. Don't forget to download the RetailMeNot app or visit their website to save on everything. Here are 2 deals that I recently found on RetailMeNot. I saw that they were offering a $10 Target gift card if you spent $50 or more at Target on groceries. So I headed on over and spent a little over $50. I got a $10 gift card for free, which will be perfect for my holiday shopping at Target. I also saw on RetailMeNot that they had a 25% off everything coupon code for World Market. I love World Market, so I was sure to head on over, and I ended up saving $21.74. I was able to get a few gift wrap supplies and some decor for our home. The fourth way to save money during the holidays is to think about ways that you can combine gifts or combine funds to get a larger gift. So what I mean by that is think about giving a couple a gift. Even a restaurant gift card for a date night is always very much appreciated. So that's just one gift. And oftentimes it is less expensive than getting individual gifts, but they still will very much appreciate that. Think about ways that you can combine funds to get a nice gift. So if you want to get a really nice gift for your parents or your dad or mom, think about going in on that gift with your siblings, and it could cost you less money and you're still able to get them something really nice. The fifth way to save money during the holidays is to avoid impulse buys. It is so easy when we are out shopping to see all these pretty decorations, to see all of the wrapping paper and gift bags and all the things, or to pick up things for ourselves, which isn't necessarily wrong, but we do have to be careful when we're looking on all kinds of websites, when we're out shopping, that we don't just randomly purchase things. And for me, I am trying to be very deliberate about what I purchase, especially as far as decor. So you're out and about and you see all these pretty things, and I often have to remind myself, I don't really know where I'm going to put this. It looks really pretty, but I can just admire it on the shelf and leave it there. The sixth way to save money during the holidays might not be something that you think about often, but I do this all the time. I bring my own drink and my own snack so that I'm not spending extra money grabbing things while I'm out because I'm hungry because I've been shopping for hours. So I usually just fill up a water bottle. You could make your own coffee so that you're not tempted to grab a coffee, which of course I do sometimes too. But if you're doing it a lot, it can really add up. Or bring your favorite drink with you. Also, pack a few snacks, especially if you're out shopping with the kids and after a couple hours, they're going to get hungry. I used to do this all the time when I took my kids grocery shopping with me. I would always bring drinks and snacks so that we had those and we weren't spending extra money on all of those. So that's just something to think about before you head out shopping. The seventh way to save money during the holidays is to remember thoughtful gifts can be very much appreciated. So what are you good at? Could you bake something? Could you craft something? Are you good at DIYs? Those gifts might not cost a ton of money, but they take time, and your time is also valuable, and people really can appreciate those kind of gifts too. So be thinking about, you know, what things that you are good at that don't cost a whole lot of money. I am not super crafty, but I have done a few DIY gifts. And don't forget that you can always buy a pretty frame and frame a photo of you and that person together, especially like grandparents and your parents. They would really like things like that. So don't think that you have to spend gobs and gobs of money to have a special and meaningful Christmas. I hope you enjoyed this video and found it helpful. Don't forget to sign up for Retail Me Not and enter the sweepstakes. I will have the information in the description box below for you.